request that the congregation please light the lamp.
For the academic year 2016-17. The academic session for the year 2016-17 commenced for the senior classes on 1st July 16. The admission process for the academic year 16 was duly carried out with an admission of 87 students into the undergraduate program with 58 boys and 29 girls. The freshers were duly inducted into the institute on August 7, 2017. The induction day was duly observed with Dr. P. Vanakamuli, Vice Chancellor, Tamil Nadu, Dr. Ambedkar Law University, Chennai. It was a good fortune having him here address the aspiring architects. He honored the function with his spirited motivational speech. McGill also conducts two postgraduate programs in architecture, MArch Environmental Architecture and MArch General, which are approved by Council of Architecture, and presently 18 students have been inducted. Further, 8 students of the 4th batch of postgraduate are getting their degrees today. Academic activities. Let me begin with our students' achievements. Ms. Rahima and Ms. Misha scored the highest as the university rank. Were shortlisted and were sent to the last batch of final year BR students successfully carried out an urban development project comprising a detailed study and proposals for the city of Madurai. The present final year is working on the proposals on below as the urban design project. The 4 year students are undergoing their 7th semester practical training in various leading architectural firms in Tamil Nadu and other parts of India. Design assignments of varying complexities were given to the students depending on their level of training, and the students were taken to build projects as relevant case studies. As a part of the curriculum, the 2nd year students are expected to study a typical rural and ancient settlement and to understand the social, economic and cultural aspects of Indian culture and civilization. Accordingly, this year also our 2nd year students spent about a week in Melkote, the historic place connected with Ramanuja, and documented the various salient features and their inferences. The third year students went on a study tour to North India to study the historic and contemporary architecture of the region. Various special lectures were organized to supplement the course subjects periodically through visiting professionals as well as in-house senior faculty members. I take this opportunity to convey my appreciation and gratitude to all these professionals who, despite their busy schedule, have kindly agreed to help us and our students through their valuable guidance. Extracurricular activities. Let me proudly again begin with our achievements. A proud achievement by our students in NASA this year, our college received the prestigious Rubens Trophy for academic excellence as well as the trophy for overall performance in South Zone of NASA, where 70 plus architectural colleges from South Zone participated. A student delegation attended the NASA National Meet at Jaipur, attended by more than 600 students from all over India and about 80 reputed architects from all over the world. They won awards in different competitions and got shortlisted in the top 20 of the Rubens Trophy for Academic Excellence in 100 plus colleges in India. Our final year student Srivardhan has been elected as the National President of NASA Council. Became the national finalist for the Young Architect Award 2017. He also won the Zakarta Trophy in ArchCut 17 conducted by NIT Trichy. His design entry was shortlisted in the top 10 entries of NASA Annual Design Competition in 100 all entries all from all over India. We have introduced a lot of co-curricular and extracurricular activities. Our day at Megan starts with various morning exercises like yoga, sports, jogging, and ends with art circle practices. Every student is involved in some or the other extracurricular activity through different clubs ranging from quiz and debates to movie club. Since last year, we have also started some value-added courses in photography, journalism, graphic design, sketching and painting, conservation, landscape, interior design, etc. The students have a choice, wide choice, to select from the certificate and diploma courses, and they can do these value-added courses as per their choices. Our newsletter, ArchiBridge, is published every 2 months, documenting different activities happening on the campus, along with student endeavors in literature and visual arts. Independence Day and Republic Day were celebrated with much enthusiasm. Most Indian festivals appear during the latter part of each year. So in turn, one after another, we enjoyed Onam, Deepavali, Christmas, topped off by Pongal and Holi. A hands-on clay workshop was conducted for the first-year students under the prime guidance of Mr. Ramesh Katti and yielded fantastic results. Students from School of Planning and Architecture, New Delhi, visited our campus as a part of their education trip. They studied our campus and interacted with our students and faculties. As a part of our continuous and constant endeavors to promote research, the faculty members are encouraged to write and present papers for different national and international conferences. A 5-day national level training program on computing in architecture in collaboration with Council of Architecture was conducted in Megan's campus during January 2007 for teachers and professionals by Professor Sabu Francis, which received a great response from all over India. Many eminent professionals conducted training sessions in the workshop. I also take immense pleasure in launching a research journal dedicated to the growth of research in architecture in India. The MAD Lab, Megan's Architectural Directory and Laboratory, the title has been approved and soon we'll be getting the international standard ISSN number, and our journal will be a referred journal, international journal. It is the first referred research journal published by an architecture college in South India. Finally, at the end of the academic year, we lived up to having a healthy mind and a healthy body by sprinting down the oval tracks through a record-breaking sports day on 12th and 13th February. Through this academic year, we have refurbished the amenities and equipments at the college premises. Simultaneously, we are striving to improve facilities at the hostels. Even the food menus are occasionally revised to suit various requests on the campus. Academic is making steady progress. A lot has been done, yet a lot is still to be done. We resiliently march on in our quest to go higher, stronger and faster all around. We have plans to intensify our academic and extracurricular activities during this academic year and continue to pursue excellence through the support of the faculty and encouragement of our management. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for recalling these overwhelming achievements by students in the year gone by. I kindly now request our respected chairman, Mr. N. Murali Kumar, to declare our graduation day over.
Graduation day of Nagesh Kuti School of Architecture has been called to order on behalf of Anna University to confer the degree in the Faculty of Architecture upon the candidates who in the examinations held in April-May 2016 for the purpose have been certified to be worthy of the same, and I declare the graduation day open.
Thank you, sir. I now request the correspondent to the Mangan Institute, Mr. J.P. Gandhi, to welcome our esteemed chief guest, Dr. V.N. Dachekaran Pillai, President of Lewar University, Rajasthan, and the guest of honor, Mr. Mohan Singh David Devdas, Principal of Miyasi Academy of Architecture, by presenting them with a token of appreciation.
Very good evening, friends. Before I introduce the eminent personalities, I would like to first congratulate our best wishes for getting graduating from our great Manning School of Architecture. My dear friends, one thing you might have realized now, while you were studying here, you will learn that you have the test. Now you would have realized that when you go for the work, you have the test, then you learn. The test is your projects. Anyway, Megan's management and the entire faculty will be there for you anytime to support, to make sure that you just move on in the career. It's a great occasion being graduated, and we have two great personalities. One is the chief guest and one is the guest of honor. The chief guest, Professor Dr. V.N. Rajasekhar Pillai, a very eminent educationist, done a lot of reforms on the education side, being holding the top post. He has served as a Vice Chancellor of Indira Gandhi National Open University, New Delhi. Also, he was the Chairman, Distance Education Council, Government of India. Served as a Vice Chancellor of Mahatma Gandhi University, Kottayam, Cochin University of Science and Technology. He served as a Vice Chairman and Chairman, University of Grand Commission, as Executive Director and National Assessment Accreditation Council, NAC, Government of India. He is elected as a Fellow of Indian Academy of Sciences, Distinguished Fellow of Kerala Academic Sciences, a Honorary Fellow of the Institution of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineers, New Delhi. He was also a Fellow of Royal Society of Chemistry and Honorary Senior Fellow of Jawaharlal Nehru Center, Advanced Scientific Research, Bangalore. Such a great educationist, such a great eminent personality among us. We are really, really happy to have you, sir. You are heartily welcome to us. The next is the guest of honor, one of the most senior academic person in Tamil Nadu in architecture teaching. Everybody knows, every architect college, every architect student might know him because he visits most of the colleges. He is none other than our guest of honor, Dr. Mohan Singh David Devdas. After his completing all his regular master of town running, he became a doctorate also. He was a consultant architect and urban planner to various government public sector undertakings. He was also a consultant member for master plan of Havilah and Neil Islands in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. He has got more than 35 years of experience in teaching and member of AACT Standing Hearing Committee, New Delhi. Expert member of Urban Development and Heritage Conservation Committee for CMDA, Tamil Nadu. He is registered member of Council of Architecture, fellow member of Indian Institute of Architects and Indian Institute of Town Planners. Right now he has held position as the Chairman and Dean of Faculty of Architecture and Planning University. And right now he is currently designated as Principal of Miyasi Academy of Architecture, Chennai. So two great personalities are going to be there to hand over the graduation certificates to you. We are very happy. So wish you all the very best. God bless you all. Thank you very much.
would like to request Mitchell ma'am to invite our chief guest to share his wisdom.
I invite distinguished chief guest Dr. V.N. Rajasekharan Pillai, President Mewar University, Rajasthan, to deliver the graduation day address.
Chairman of the Mountain Ooty School of Architecture, Advocate N. Murali Kumaran. Today's guest of honor, eminent architect, Dr. Mohan Singh and David Devadas, principal of this institution, Dr. Gauri Shivkar, Professor J.P. Gandhi, distinguished members of the board of this institution, members of the faculty of the architecture school as well as the design school in this institution, dear students who are graduating from this institution during the fourth graduation day, and other students who are studying in this institution, other members of the staff, non-teaching staff, well wishes of this institution, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, let me thank the management and the entire institution staff for extending me an invitation to come over here and participate in the fourth graduation day celebrations of this institution. I am extremely glad that this institution, founded almost 10 years ago, is growing in the right perspective, providing the right kind of architecture education to the youngsters. The infrastructure development as well as the faculty development in this institution has been phenomenal. Had occasion to visit this institution earlier once. Even otherwise had almost very regular information about this institution from the chairman of this institution, who happens to be one of my colleague who worked with me in Indira Gandhi National Open University as well as in the University Grants Commission when I was in Delhi. I take this opportunity to congratulate the principal, the teachers, the administrative staff, the technical staff, all those who have helped in bringing up this institution to this level. I also take this opportunity to congratulate all the youngsters who will receive the degree of Anna University. I congratulate those who have excelled in the various branches of architecture education at the university level as well as in the college level. Graduation day is a great day for a graduating student. She or he will remember that day in their life, all the time. It is the culmination of the hard work they have been doing, the systematic studies they have been undergoing, and finally they are going to get an evidence for their hard-earned achievements. And usually a degree is considered as a culmination of the systematic studies. But particularly for a professional degree like architecture, this degree is only a beginning of foreign education. You are just getting a license to learn, license to delve into the real realm of architecture education. So it is not just the end. You are really going to learn more and more things from the society, from the field, from the profession. And this gives you an opportunity or a license to do such things. Probably you will be learning more things, integrating more things into your acquired learning in this area. And during the convocation, we used to really congratulate the students and bless the students. And when you receive a degree, of course, you should also imagine that even now, to get such a professional degree, it is a brave, very great thing. It is not that easy. And if you just look at the whole education in this country as a whole, getting a degree is even now considered as a very, very important thing, because only less than 20% of your age group get the opportunity of getting even a regular general degree. That means you are a privileged few. You are privileged in the sense that you are getting a degree of a university, Anna University, through this illustrious institution, and then you are getting a professional degree. You are going to get a degree which is going to be very well practiced. So you are the cream of the graduating group in the country, and therefore you have also responsibility to the country, to your profession. And I don't want to make a big speech on architecture or the subject of architecture in this context, but it is I can understand. I'm basically a scientist, a chemist. I can understand that it's a highly interdisciplinary and transdisciplinary area of academic intervention. Architecture, as you probably might have studied, the very meaning of the word is architecture. Again, usually all these words have your meaning, original meaning from Greek or Latin. The meaning is archi means chief, arch. Texture means builder or carpenter. That is the meaning. And the architecture relates from chief architecture or master builder. That is the word architecture. So from that it has originated. But now you just look at the meaning of architecture. It is not just building. It is not just design. You will see molecular architecture. You will see architecture of computer software systems. Architecture of database. Architecture of living systems. So even to describe abstract things, architecture in mathematics, architecture in music, even in abstract things, this word architecture is used. Originally, the meaning was master builder or master carpenter. That was the original meaning, but it's not just like that. It is a in almost all areas of thinking, abstract thinking, the word architecture is coming. And therefore, you might have studied the basic principles of architecture. When we consider the Indian architecture, we have both the Vastu Vidya and Vastu Shastra. Vastu Vidya is the knowledge and concept and theories and philosophies behind architecture. Vastu Shastra is the layout and design and all these things with drawings. So, not only in India, in all cultures, whether it be religious related cultures, you will see such historical dimensions of architecture. And it is very important that when you go with a degree of architecture,
you also understand the ramifications of the bird architecture and the fields in which you are going to engage in the future. So architecture is one of the oldest disciplines of education and training. It is related to a great many disciplines such as mathematics, economics, art history, sociology, civil engineering, and mechanical engineering. Its connection with a multitude of different disciplines has given increased social responsibility to the discipline of architecture. Architecture is not just designing buildings for different purposes. It is designing to fit dimensions of various perspectives and environments like physical, social, and cultural and ecological. The art of designing and construction and its science should be performed by people who are self-confident, socially, generally cultured, who can generate practical solutions and are forward-looking. Designing structures which are in harmony with humanity and its environment has been a great challenge for architects across history. Nowadays we call it organic architecture. You might have heard about organic architecture. If you hear about organic agriculture, organic farming, similarly organic architecture. This philosophy of organic architecture was best exemplified by, architects are here, they might have told you also all these things. It was best exemplified by Frank Lloyd Wright, who lived during the period 1867 to 1959 in America, Pennsylvania. And his famous creation, this one, it is considered as the world most important, one of the most important architectural site. It is the Falling Water House in Pennsylvania, which is a private house of a very distinguished and very prominent businessman, Kaufman. Kaufman is known as Kaufman House. Even now, he is one of the top 10 sites to be visited by anybody that is recorded like this. It is known as Falling Water House, which has been called the best all-time work of American architecture. The best all-time work of American architecture. Even now it is there. It is on a falling water, this particular house. And this was the private house of Edgar J. Kaufman, owner of the Kaufman's department stores during those days. Organic architecture is a philosophy of architecture which promotes harmony between human habitation and the natural world. This is achieved through design approaches that aim to sympathetically and well integrated with the science. Thus, buildings, furnishings, surroundings become part of a unified intellectual and interrelated composition. Essentially, organic architecture is also the literal design of every element, exterior or interior, of a building relating to one another, reflecting the symbiotic ordering systems of nature, mimicking the systems of nature. Organic architecture after Second World War reflected cybernetics and informatic models of life, as is reflected in the later work of another famous architect known as Buckminster Fuller. I am a chemist. Bearing his name, there is an organic molecule, Buckminster Fullerene. And for which Nobel Prize has been awarded in chemistry. It is known as Buckminster Fullerene. And Buckminster Fuller was a great architect. I am just giving examples of how that the thinking of architects are reflected in other areas, in other disciplines. And Buckminster Fullerene and Fullerenes are now a class of new molecules with a very specific shape of the design of this particular architect, who also lived, I mean, he died in 1983, maybe 80 years he might have lived, 1983 he died. And he was an architect and planner, and that the famous work is the geodesic. What's that? Geodesic dome. That's Buckminster Fullerene. So I'm just trying to find out examples from which other disciplines have benefited from architectural concepts, architectural drawings. Similarly, the architect and planner David Pearson proposed a list of routes towards the design of organic architecture. That's also very, very famous. It's just like the Bible for organic architecture. I will just read out some of the processes which he has mentioned in a document he developed during those days, which is known as the Gaia Charter of Organic Architecture. I think you should read it. It's all available. I am not in the field of architecture, but when I read this, I was really feeling overwhelmed with how this area is connected with all other disciplines. And this Gaia Charter of Organic Architecture reads, I will just read out a few clauses from that. It starts like that. Let the design be inspired by nature and be sustainable, healthy, conserving, and diverse. Let the design unfold like an organism from the seed within. Let the design exist in the continuous present and begin again, and follow the flows and be flexible and adaptable. Let this design satisfy social, physical, and spiritual needs. Let the design grow out of the site and be unique. Let the design celebrate the spirit of youth, play, and surprise. Let the design express the rhythm of music and the power of dance. How beautiful this is. How architecture should be in conformity, in unison with nature. This is the thing. So lot of ideas, not only for you architecture, professionals of architects, it is for even anybody, a social scientist, a philosopher, a thinker, a musician, a designer, a scientist. These are all, they get ideas and motivations from such expressions. So I mentioned about Richard Buckminster Fuller. He was an American architect, systems theorist. He was a systems theorist. He was a designer and an inventor. His most famous cultural design, of course, we mentioned already, geodesic dome. Carbon molecules. When was it actually? It was in the 1990s, or 2000. The Nobel Prize in Chemistry was given to Buckminster Fullerene. They looked at this dome and designed the molecules from just carbon, 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 carbon only. And it's very, very strong molecules. And now these Fullerenes are used in many other fields, in nanomaterials, even in medicine, it is used for drug delivery. So such architectural concepts give lot of inspiration for other fields as well. That the Gaia principles or Gaia Magna Carta of organic architecture, which I mentioned, it was again promoted by a foundation known as Gaia Foundation, which is a loosely knit network organization that promotes ecologically sustainable development. So it shows the role of architecture in helping helping an ecologically sustainable development. We talk about the sustainable development, United Nations talk about the sustainable development, and you know the role of architecture in number of UN related organizations in sustainable development. So this particular group of architects see the earth as a super organism, a super, if we call them, we know the smallest organism, maybe a cell, but they are as a super organism, life, with full of life and all the elements together. Similarly, such concepts, of course, we mentioned a few examples from the US and other developed countries, but in our country also, historically and traditionally, we had the Vastu Shastra as a Hindu system of architecture, which literally translates into the science of architecture. That's the meaning. Vastu Shastra means science of architecture. That is the meaning of the word. It incorporates traditional Hindu and in some cases Buddhist beliefs. Such designs, as we know, are intended to integrate architecture with nature, relative functions of various parts of the structure, and ancient beliefs utilizing geometric patterns. We know about, for example, whether it be the Kollu or the Yendra, the symmetry, the directional alignments, all these things are there. All of us know about Angkor Wat, that is a World Heritage Site and one of the world's largest Hindu temple. It is in Cambodia. It celebrates the Hindu Vastu Shastra. In Vastu Shastra, this Cambodian temple deploys the same circles and squares grid architecture as described in Indian Vastu Shastra. If you just look at modern analytical architecture also, you can see lot of designs. So lot of creativity, lot of philosophy, psychology, social underpinnings, all these things are involved in architectural education, and that's why I mentioned that you might not have all these things, but you will see when you practice this profession, you will see that it is a vastly growing interdisciplinary and transdisciplinary area of human intervention. That's the point I wanted to emphasize. And also, if you just look at our Puranas, we had the two master architects, one for Devas, the Vishwamitra, and one for the Asuras, Maya. So the two famous in the Devas, they have an architect, and the Asuras, they have an architect. So this is from our thinking onwards. And then we have also very, very many eminent architects. They might not have studied, they might not have any degree of BR or anything, but very eminent architect. And architecture has been promoted by very eminent rulers in this country. Ashoka, Chhatrapati Shivaji, Rajaraja Chola, all these Rajas also promoted architecture in a very big way, and you have a big number of examples also. So, we have in the modern architecture, we have names like Charles Correia, Satish Gujral, several names are there in the field of architecture. So it is a very promising field. I am very sure that the type of knowledge and type of skills you have gathered from this institution, and then with your own independent and creative interventions and integration of other thinkings and other related areas into the field of architecture, you are definitely going to excel. And once again, let me congratulate each and every one of you. Let me congratulate the teachers for producing a bright group of young architects. You should be thankful to this institution and the learners and the teachers for providing you the right kind of education. In any convocation address, when I go to Tamil Nadu, large number of universities in Tamil Nadu and autonomous colleges, I have given graduation addresses. And I used to say, the degree is not an end. I already mentioned, degree is not an end. Of course, you know, in Tamil there is a famous famous saying, Kattra the Kaiman Nadavu, Kallada the Ulagadavu. On this graduation day, you should remember, you should have the feeling that what you have learned is this handful. What remains to be learned is as big as this earth. What is that? What is that feeling? It is nothing but humility. A feeling of humility. When you get a degree, when you get a higher degree, when you get a higher recognition, you should feel humble. And this particular saying, I do not know where in which writing of Tamil it is there. Kattra the Kaiman Nadavu, Kallada the Ulagadavu. That is nothing but an expression of humility. A person getting a degree should feel humble. And he or she should know that there is lot of things to be learned. And what I have learned is this handful only. And only people with such feeling can learn new things, can train himself or herself into new areas. And I am sure that you will continue to learn and you will excel in your field. Congratulations to you once again.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your in-depth knowledge on the various aspects of the ancient and futuristic aspects of the art field of architecture. I again request Mr. J.P. Gandhi to present the token of appreciation to our chief guest, Mr. V.N. Rajasekaran Pillai. I also request Mr. Gandhi to present the token of appreciation to our guest of honor, Mr. Monsi Devan Dindas. And may I now request the guest of honor, Mr. Monsi Devan Dindas, to address the graduating architects.
Good afternoon. Respected Mr. N. Muralikumaran, Chairman of Lagan School of Architecture, Honorable Chief Guest of today, Dr. V. N. Rajasekaran Pillai, President Navar University, Mr. J. P. Gandhi, Correspondent MOSA, Dr. Gauri Shulkar, Principal MOSA, Professor Ranganathan, Advisor MOSA, members of the staff, invited guests, parents, print and news media, graduates, ladies and gentlemen and students. It's a great honor and privilege for me to be here today as the guest of honor at the fourth graduation day ceremony of Mekan School of OT School of Architecture. At the outset, I'd like to congratulate all the young graduates, architects who have entered the profession from today onwards. I believe our education is essentially about the values instilled on young people, woven into their professional skills, knowledge and sensitivities. Beginning with our education, these values carry us into the path of service and nation building. We define our profession as good people who profess the same good values. We must be clear that to be a professional is to profess values and to realize those values through our creative work. I propose we architects here today agree to have such a code that becomes a rite of passage from being ordinary lay people and to students and now into a professional. What are these values? I wish to highlight few generic beliefs, themes and causes that have taken us all on an exciting journey. These values must become an integral part of a professional oath and code of behavior. Equality. The equality of all things, living things, particularly human beings, is fundamental to our work. Can architecture and urban planning further the cause of equality among people? Can our designs, skill act, as channel and bars of access and opportunity for others? Can we design urban systems that make access to education, healthcare and shelter equitable? Yes, we can. Justice. These values evoke a need for justice and fairness. A rule applied on one must be applied to all, and there must be no exception to a rule meant for everyone. We have to ask if it is fair for one city to consume 20 times the energy per capita of another. We have pondered over the excesses of a minority of greedy people at the cost of majority. These are concerns we all share. Do such values impinge on how we design humane settlements? Definitely they do. Worldview. The times we live in require us to have a worldview and understand that we cannot survive in isolation. Be it climate change, sustainability, human rights, nuclear war, terrorism, or trade. Our shared global space is affected. We must respect diverse culture and coexist with many beliefs. In the deepening urban context of India, where we will all share denser urban space, common social and economic facilities, and to make community decisions together, it is an integral part of architectural planning. Regional context. At the same time, we have to build and to design contextually. We have to draw our inspirations from styles evolved from the past that have addressed the climate, local materials, craftsmanship, appropriate technologies and culture. The design of any artifact begins with the understanding of its physical place. How does context become the starting point of design? How do building programs and functions reflect the culture of the users? How are we contributing to? How are we detracting from regional cultures? Liberty. I think each one of us demands our personal freedom and liberty. Pursue our own fate, explore our own talents, and be ourselves in every creative manner possible. Liberty is also an attitude about the involvement and participation of the users in our works. How do we make our design processes and interactive, more interactive and participatory? How do our plans gift humanity more opportunities and choices? Do we see trampling on the rights of one minority as a theft of freedom from us all? If we want the country to grow, we have to create large scale transport and basic facilities, basic services. We need infrastructure. However, people will be affected. That is inevitable. Are we including them in our plans as part of the cost and benefits? We can and we must do this. Fraternity. Each of us senior architects today have undergone a number of personal transformations and reincarnations. We have redefined ourselves, explored new manifestations, and lived different avatars in life search. Yes, we are different, but we are the same. What binds us together is a sense of fraternity, sisterhood and brotherhood, that attracts us and makes us want to come together as we are doing here today. When I meet my gurus and my professional colleagues, these are the kinds of concepts and values that mold our dialogues, discussions, and guide our thoughts. The strength of shared values gives us a sense of meaning and assurance. I want to expand our fraternal circle to include each student and new professional sitting here today to be a part of a professional fraternity. I want you on this graduation day to think of your life and your values, modern ideas. All of us on this path have been deeply concerned about the modern era and globalization. This has been a time that took away dignity from the caste person. I'm sure all of you would agree. A time that turned self-sufficient homesteads into monocrop commercial fields. A time that pushed ill-prepared, illiterate people into chaotic cities. Do we see modern architecture as a mere style or as a social commitment? Do we see architecture and urban planning as agents to enhance the human condition? I know we do. Knowledge. Ignorance breeds ugliness. The collection of facts is essential for us to form ideas. An idea is a logical relationship between two or more facts. Analyzing and understanding the relationships between related areas allows us to form concepts. Without concepts, we cannot state problems. Concepts are the seeds of good design. Each young architect must set your own standards and define their own character through the values they adhere to. The love for knowledge, the habit of reading, and the interest in analysis are not just activities, but essential values for professionals. In the ultimate analysis, we as architects are not just creators, we are builders. We cannot live in the world of mere thoughts and words. We have to plant our feet firmly on earth and leave our footprint. We are thinker doers whose ideas must mesh with the materials around us and the technology available. We must address the society we live in and build for. Openness. Our debates, dialogues, presentations, and even arguments have made us all more open to constructive criticism and self-evaluation. Teaching was never a one-way process. It is a back and forth flow of sharing and questioning. Dialogues and questions are more important than monologues and answers. Openness is an essential professional value. You leave here today more open to constructive criticism than the day you arrived. Your education here has made you so. Legacy. These values were passed on to me from my teachers, senior architects, and by the examples of true friends. Some of my teachers were vice friends and colleagues at work. I learned from being with them, seeing how they dealt with issues and understanding how they resolved problems. These values were woven into the fabric of everything they said and underpinned their worldview. It is now my legacy to hold ideas and values as my only belt. As it is my duty to pass on this belt onto you, I have chosen these values to form a code, and hopefully they will become an oath taken by all architects as a rite of passage from being an ordinary layman, transforming into a true professional upon graduation. This transformation is the essence of your stay here at the Meghan Scooty School of Architecture. Congratulations once again. Bachelor of Architecture. I expect great things to happen to me. Good luck and God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. I believe the words of wisdom prove to be the testaments of a healthy and prosperous professional career for the young architects. Now, may I request our head of the department, VR Professor Indrayani Joshi, to please come forward.
Distinguished chief guest, I, Professor Indrayani Joshi, present to you the candidates who have been certified by duly appointed examiners to be qualified to receive the bachelor's degree in architecture from Anna University for the examination held in April-May 2016.
I request the rank holders, Rahima M.R. to score the biggest rank for all candidates. Students will be presented with a cash prize of Rs. 5,000 each. Next, please be ready. Next is Ms. Risha Kumar.
Yeah. Ramachandran, Devang P, Niveta, Prabhu M,
our principal
request all the graduates and postgraduates to please stand up for the conferment of their degree. By the virtue of the authority delegated by the Anna University, I admit you to the bachelor's degree and master's degree in architecture for which you have been declared qualified in this university, and in token thereof you have been presented with this degree, and I authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of your degrees. Thank you.
Now I would like to request our esteemed chairman, Mr. N. Vodhikumar, to carry out the blessing ceremony, and the fellow graduates are to follow him.
Now I request all the graduates to take the oath.
Please stand.
Good evening, friends. Rather than a word of thanks, rather a word of happiness. First, I'd like to thank, I'm really happy that the eminent educationist Rajshekhar Pillai is among us. Really, thank you, sir, for your presence and also for your bird's eye view on organic architecture. It was really eye opening for a few people like us. The second, or the guest of honor, the academician, Dr. Man Singh. Sir, for your esteemed presence and also giving a keynote address, especially a special thanks for the professional ethics and values an architect has to follow. Thank you so much for that. I'd like to thank our chairman, Vodhikumaran sir, always been there for us, motivating in positive side in every way we need, is there for us. Thank you, sir, for your presence. The principal, Navi, no words to say, very dynamic, authentically carry out along with this entire team. I'd like to thank the entire teaching faculty for your presence and making this function a grand success. Our advisor, Ranganathan sir, is always there for us, always gives a very positive advice. And this function is also, again, a lot of input is given us and making it very successful. I'd like to thank the entire press community, both written, write, virtual, broadcasting media, for giving us continuous support promoting our brand in daily newspapers and media. Thank you so much for your presence. I'd like to thank the entire student volunteers. In fact, for the last 2 days they are working, making this function a great success. Thank you so much, my dear students. I'd like to thank the graduating students who have come all the way. Really happy to have all of you, along with your parents. A very big thanks to parents for making your presence here. Thank you so much. We'd like to thank the entire administrative team. The entire administrative team is carrying out all the things, and also the catering team. Give a big hand to them, because they are always in the backbone for the success. So thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you so much, sir. I kindly request the respected chairman to declare the graduation day closed.
I declare the graduation day is now closed.
I kindly request the graduates all gathered in this hall here to stand up for the national anthem, and please remove your caps while the national anthem is being played.
Shubha Ashish Amar.